Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, and for today's video I will be doing how to contour a round face. Okay, I have a round face and it is really important to know the proper technique to make a round face into an oval. Bit of tip and trick of contouring. So here I am, how to contour a round face. If you want to know how to contour a round face to get a perfect sculpted look, then please keep on watching. So guys, to contour my face, I will be using an angled brush. This type of brush is amazing just to contour your face because it is angled and it sits perfectly into the hollows of your cheeks like this. So it is really easy to just place the contour into the perfect area and then blend with this. So I will be using this brush. You can use any brand brush. This is by Oriflame I'm using. This brush is by Oriflame. But you can use any brush that you want, okay? And to contour my face, I will be using my Freedom Pro Stroke Palette. I have already reviewed this product before, so I will link it in the description box, or in the end I will link it over here. So you can guys just check it out, the review of this product. This is amazing, I just love this. It also comes with its own brush, this type of brush, and this is also amazing guys, because it is a flat brush, totally flat brush. So it's really amazing to place your product exactly onto the area just like this. Even it is really easy to contour your nose the perfect angle. So yeah, I use this brush mostly for contouring my nose, but for my cheeks I always use this angle brush from Oriflame. To contour your face, you don't only need this Freedom palette or any contour palette. You can use any matte eyeshadow, for example these type of matte eyeshadows, or if you have an eyeshadow palette like I have one, this from Makeup Revolution, the Salvation palette. In this you have this amazing matte brown eyeshadow. You can use even this one to contour your face. Just one problem is there, that this brown is really too dark. So you just need to take a very little amount of this brown eyeshadow, and the key to get a perfect contour for this brown eyeshadow is just blending. You just need to keep on blending, and you will get a perfect contour look. I have one more palette, this one. This is from Lakme 925 palette. I have a brown shade over here as well, but this won't go because this is slightly shimmer and we don't want any shimmer in our contouring. So we need a really matte shade, so this one won't work. Let's keep it aside. So now let's begin with the contouring, and for today's video the main keyword was to contour our round face. I have a round face. So guys, always remember that you have to contour from your ear top, from over here till where your lips, to your lips corner, okay? You have to contour in this direction. Just take your brush, place it over here from your ear top to your lip corner. You see this thing, this line. You have to contour this line. Whenever we make fish face for contouring, just like this, can you see? The hollows are shown from the mid of our ear, from this side to the to our lip corners, right? Sorry. Okay. So whenever we make fish face like this, can you see the hollows are formed from this mid ear, the lip corners? This line is formed always. But we don't have a square face, or we don't have a long face that we really need to cut our face. So what we will be doing, we will be contouring from our ear top to our lip corners. Okay, so this will be our main guideline to contouring. Always remember this guys, okay. I'm going to take this darker shade from my palette on tip of my brush, okay. Don't take any product on the side of your brushes. Always take your product on the tip of your brush. Always start with very little product and then go on building up the product. So we have the product. Now we'll remove the excess. So now let's begin with this. So guys, as you can see, I have drawn a straight line from my ear top to where my lip corners are in the parallel line, but my down line ends where my eye corners are. Can you see this? From my eye corner, if you make a straight line my contouring just ends over here. I have to just contour this much of area. Now I have just mirror line, so I'm going to just blend this out. So guys, I have done with my blending and you can see the difference between this cheek and this cheek. This one is much more sculpted one where I have this chubby cheese over here. Okay, so now I'm going to contour my other cheek as well. So guys, I'm done with my contouring this side as well. Now as you can see, I have a much more sculpted look over here. But this side is little bit muddy. Okay, and you see my contour has spread all over and that has come beyond my eye corner. So I have done this purposefully to tell you guys one thing. This mistake is made by everybody in the beginning. Whenever a person just learn to do makeup, this mistake is a very common mistake made by everyone. Even I have made this mistake in my beginning, okay? To correct this mistake, I have an amazing tip for you guys. What you all need is just your makeup sponge. You can use any makeup sponge. You can use your beauty blender. You can use a round shape sponge. This type of sponge, any sponge, and all you need is a powder. It might be a skin shade powder or maybe a translucent powder. You can also use your same palette and you can take this lightest shade from this palette to just correct your mistake, or you can also use a translucent powder. The one I am using is by Kralin. This is Kralin translucent powder. The shade number is TL2. Okay, there's only one shade, TL2, which is a translucent powder. So I will be using this one. And the tip and the trick is baking. Yes guys, you heard me correct, baking. What actually baking mean is just to take your skin shade powder or a translucent powder and to place it all over your mistakes and just let it sit over there for a while, okay? And after that, we will just remove it with a normal powder brush and mistake will be gone. So I will be taking my translucent powder from Kralin. This is what it looks like, okay? Now I will be taking my sponge and I'm going to take a really nice amount of it, okay? Now I will be placing this powder over my mistakes. Can you see this? My contour has gone beyond the corner, so I will be placing it over here. I'm going to apply the same translucent powder under my contour. Can you see this? Now I'm going to keep this powder over here for a while. Till then we will just see how to highlight our face, okay? In a quick way. I'm going to use this shimmery shade and I'm now going to highlight my cheekbones. Now guys, always remember this, we have a round face, okay? So when we are highlighting our cheekbones, don't take it all over your temples, okay? We just need to keep it till here because we just need to highlight center of the face, okay? So we are just going to keep the highlight till over here. We are not going to take it all over till the temples. So I've used a fluffy brush to highlight it. You can use a fan brush, you can use a blush brush, any brush, or you can also use your fingers, but I like this. Just touch it, you can feel your cheekbones over here. So I'm just going to highlight my two fingers area, okay? Now I've placed my product, I'm going to blend it out. Can you see this guys? I have just highlighted this area. Now I'm going to do the same thing on this side and a little bit on my nose tip. A little bit on forehead or my cupid bows. And whatever is left in my brush, I'm just going to apply this on my chin. Now guys, it has been a while. I have just kept this translucent powder over my mistakes. So now I will be taking my large powder brush, or you can also use your sponge, again no problem. I will be using my brush and I'll dust this off. Guys, can you see this? The mistakes have been corrected. Now, because of my baking, my contour has been so sharp, I really need to blend it a little bit more. I'm just going to blend a little bit. Ta-da! So guys, here I'm done with contouring my cheeks. Now it's time to contour our jawline, okay? Because we have a round face and we want to make it look a little bit oval, right? So what we really need to do is we are going to contour our jawline. We are not going to contour it exactly from here, but a little bit from inside side, okay? The hollow of our jawline, so that our double chin has been hidden and we can have a longer face. So I'm going to take again the same brush, the same product, okay? I'm just going to place it over here. I'm going to make a V. One, two. And just blend this. So now guys, I'm done with my contouring my jawline. Now it's time to give a final touch. Whatever product is left on a brush, I'm going to place this on my temples. I'm not going to contour my foreheads because this is a round face. And I already have a small forehead. If I'll contour it from here, my forehead will look much more smaller, and I really don't want that to happen. So whatever product is left on this brush, I'm just going to place it over my temples. And now, what I really do is, to complete my makeup, I just need to apply a little bit of more mascara because I feel the mascara is not up to mark. I'll apply it and I'll meet you in just 1 second. So guys, here's my finished look. I hope you are enjoyed watching this video, and this video might be quite helpful for you all. So don't forget to give this video a very, very, very big thumbs up if you liked it. Share with your friends and don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, guys, okay? It won't cost you anything, okay? It won't cost you anything, not even a single penny. You just need to hit that red button, okay? We say subscribe. Please do subscribe to my YouTube channel and hit the bell button for more notification and updates. And do follow me on all my social media links, on my Facebook, on my Instagram, on my Twitter. All the links will be given in the description box for you guys. So do go out and check them out. And I'll see you in my next video. Bye. Take care.